I'm here with Stephen Munitones, founder of the World Open Water Swimming Association, or WOWSA, also a marathon swimming historian. We are just days away from the Tokyo Olympic Games, so we're profiling the 25 men and 25 women competing in the Olympic 10K marathon swim in Odaiba Marine Park. Today, we're talking about Anastasia Kirpichnikova. Stephen, tell us about Anastasia.
This is a 20-year-old from Russia who has a lot of upside. In fact, if there's anybody who has more upside than her, I would not know who they are. She's blazing fast in the pool, 159 in the 200-meter freestyle, 406 in the 400-meter freestyle, and 821 in the 800-meter freestyle. That puts her truly at the top edges of pool speed amongst the 25 finalists. But she has a lack of real international experiences. So obviously that appears to me that the Russian Swimming Federation identified her early on in her career and said, hey, you know what? You may not medal in the 800 meter free or the 400 meter free in the pool, but you can medal sometime in the future in the Olympic marathon swim. So I think that's how she was identified. She got eighth in the Olympic qualifier. She was frankly a minute off of Anna Olas, who won that race. So it wasn't like she was within a few seconds. She was eighth by a little bit. But again, think about it. She doesn't have that much experience. In fact, I looked through the FINA database and I couldn't find her name in the results. That's not to say that she hasn't done a 5K or 10K race domestically in Russia, because she had to in order to qualify for the Olympic qualification race. But she probably has the least experience of anybody out there, at least from what I know. I have to admit, I've never seen her before, but just looking at her pool times and looking at her lack of experience on the international stage, this tells me that this young lady, this 20-year-old Anastasia, has a lot of upside. She could surprise a lot of people in the Odaiba Marine Park. I have to admit, I don't know if she performs better in warm water versus cold water, simply because she doesn't have a documented track history of a lot of races. So, I always give the benefit of the doubt. So with those pool times, with the lack of experience, I think she could surprise a lot of people out there and move up in her seedings and finish, higher than expected.
Stephen, sounds like a real wild card with some blazing fast speed, so you can't count her out. What have you seen from people relatively new to the 10K circuit? How do they approach it? What are some of the pitfalls of someone with a little less experience, especially on the Olympic stage like this?
Yeah, well, actually, there's so few examples of someone with so little experience actually competing at the Olympics. We do have that kind of experience, or those kind of swimmers with that lack of experience performing well on the world championship stage. And though they have plenty of experiences, however, the experiences where the swimmers are shocked are even greater. In other words, if you're a great 1500 meter swimmer and your country identifies you as someone who should do a 10K race, in some cases, those swimmers perform well. But in most cases, those swimmers, their first or second experience in a 10K race is actually fairly disappointing. They don't realize the sustained pace of a 10K marathon swim without flip turns. This is the big, big difference. There's one thing to swim up and down a pool, 30 laps with a flip turn. And Quinn, you and I know very well, you're supposed to swim hard into the wall and push hard off. But in fact, it gives you a little bit of break. It's not supposed to, and I'm not, Sun Yang of China, but, I think most swimmers view that wall as a little bit of change of pace. 10K race, you don't have any opportunity to rest. It's punishing. 1K, 2K, 5K, 6K, 8K, 9K, 10K. The race seems to go on and on and on. And for those newcomers, they have to get accustomed to that. I don't know how accustomed Anastasia is, but her pool times are so fast and she's so young. Sometimes when you're young, you're also innocent. You don't know what exactly to expect. And anybody at this level should expect, I want to see myself up on that Olympic podium. I want to see my flag playing, waving proudly amongst in front of a global audience. Anastasia undoubtedly has that, has those dreams, envisions herself being in that position. So sometimes that ignorance is okay, and you just go for it.
Ignorance can be bliss. So we got a ton of speed, we got a ton of potential, but there is a learning curve to this event. So that experience could hurt her. Steven, where do you see her coming out? What's your final prediction for Anastasia in the 10K?
This is a hard one. I mean, she could finish as you know, 10th through 12th. She could also just be shell-shocked and she could finish, you know, 20 to 25th. It's that unknown to me. I'm going to peg her as the top 15. I think as a 20-year-old, her time to shine will be in Paris and in London.
All right. You heard it here. Thanks so much, Stephen.